गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन आर इंग्लिश ऑनलाइन क्लास विद द कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ द चैप्टर 1 द हाउस विद द गोल्डन विंडोज। टुडे वी विल डू द एक्सप्लेनेशन पार्ट ऑफ द अदर टू पेजेस। वी हैव लर्नड इन अ प्रीवियस लेसन दैट स्टीव वाज अ बॉय हु लिव्ड ऑन अ फार्म विद हिज पेरेंट्स। ही टुक केयर ऑफ द कैटल्स ऑन हिज फार्म। वन सैटरडे हिज फादर टोल्ड हिम टू गो आउट एंड लर्न समथिंग गुड। So he went to see the golden windows which he used to see at the time of sunset from his house. He started his journey that day. He reached there, but he saw that there were no golden windows. That was the house of his mother's friend, Mrs. Campbell. He asked her, "Where are the golden windows?" She laughed. Because there were no golden windows. So what will happen after that, we will get to know after reading the other two pages. So be ready with your English course book. Mrs. Campbell moved her head from side to side and laughed. "We are poor farming people," she said, "and I don't think there will ever be any gold on our windows." She laughed because there were no golden windows. So she said, "We are poor people. We don't have enough money to make our windows gold in color. Anyway, glass is better than gold." So see through. She told that we don't have golden windows. She asked Steve to sit down and rest. She brought him a cup of milk and some cake. She then called her little girl Paula, a child of his own age, to sit with him. Mrs. Campbell went back to her work, leaving the two children together to walk and play. Now, Mrs. Campbell called her daughter Paula. She was his own age. Now they both were sitting together and talking and playing. Mrs. Campbell went to the work on her farm. Steve and Paula wandered around her family's farm. Paula showed him her black calf, Princess, that had a white star on its forehead. They crept up to the roof to see her cat and her kittens. Now they both were, Steve and Paula, were walking here and there, and Paula showed the animals on her farm. There were black calf, kittens, cat, and others. Pet animals were there on the farm. Soon they became friends, and Steve asked her about the golden windows. Now they both were talking to each other, they both were playing. So Steve at that time asked a question that, "Do you know about the golden windows?" Paula said that she knew all about them. Paula also knew about the golden windows. "You have taken the wrong way," she laughed. "Come with me to the top of the hill behind our house, and I will show you the house you are looking for." When they both were going to that side, Paula told him that, "You are going to the wrong way. That side, there were no golden windows. I knew the exact place where the golden windows were there." As they walked, she told him that the golden windows could only be seen as the sun goes down. Now, as they both were walking towards the golden windows, she told him that, "We can only see the golden windows at the time of sunset." "Yes, I know that," said Steve. Steve was in favor of this statement because he also saw the golden windows at the time of sunset from his home. They waited, and just as the sun was starting to go down, Paula turned and pointed. "There it is," she said. Now, as the sun set, Paula showed him the golden windows. "And one day, just like you, I am going to go and look for that house." And she said, "As today you came here to see the golden windows, one day I will also come that place to see the golden windows." There, on a hill far away, stood a house with windows of gold. Looking at it, Steve saw that the house was his own. Now, Paula showed him the house that was his house only. And there were no golden windows in his house. So he was very surprised. Why? Its windows were blazing like golden flames. That was a question in Steve's mind. But suddenly, Steve realized what had happened. But now he got the answer. And what was the answer? The golden rays of the setting sun fell on both the hills and made the glass windows of both the houses glitter like gold. That was the answer of the question. Thanks, Paula, and goodbye, said Steve. I need to go home before it gets too dark. Now, Steve got the answer. He knew the golden windows, so he went to his home. So, Paula said goodbye to him. I need to go home before it gets too dark. Paula stood in the sunset, gazing and waving at him as he walked down the hill. The sun had sunk below the horizon by the time Steve returned home. Horizon means the line where the sky seems to touch the land or sea. Now, when he reached there, the sun sat down. But the lamplight shone through the windows almost as bright as the golden windows he had seen. When he opened the door, his mother came over to hug him. When he reached there, his mother opened the door and he reached to his home now. His father, who sat by the fire, looked up and smiled. "Did you have a good day?" asked his father. The father asked him, "For what purpose I send you? Have you done that work today?" "Yes," said Steve. "A very good day. I am very happy today." "Did you learn anything?" asked his father. His father asked him, "For what purpose I sent you today? Have you done that work? Have you learned something?" "Yes," said Steve. "I learned that our house too has windows of gold." And he said to his father that today I have learned that our house had golden windows. So students, that's all in today's lesson. Have a nice day.